And so Geshe-la is saying we're starting this new year, the second year of your study program. And to start this program is very important first to settle a good motivation, the proper motivation. Because if you get proper motivation, then the result of your studies will be favorable, will be good as well. So first we start with settling a good proper motivation. So usually when we speak about listening to teaching Dharma, when we speak about Dharma, first we have to check the way we are listening to this teaching is very important. And as is it taught in the Lamrim Chamo in the great stages of the path, it is say you should be free from the three faults of an improper vessel, yeah, recipient vessel, and you should have the six idea or the six correct conception or consideration to listen to the teaching properly. And usually in the Lamrim Chambos is mentioned we should avoid the three faults that are similar. The analogy is like that. There's a recipient, a vessel, and he might have three faults. The first one, that he might be upside down. Yeah. The second one, maybe it's on the correct side, but it's unclean, it's dirty. And the third one is that he might have a broken bottom, a leaking bottom. Yes, there are the three faults of a recipient or of a vessel. So this is the analogy we're going to see now.
And ne kabu patabu maimba se kane logor sina ani ne kabu tsani tikan ma zatun kane lugi ne ko nal rog mare sira pe te na ji ma zo chi ne sa tre ne de wa ji ani ko semba te ne ma ne ba ji ani kas ka le yin de wa ji an chu ma ne ba sina ko chi tre ne de ba ina ma de ba do ni na no ma ro se kala ni ti na no ma ro chi pa ani ko chi ko ma go ba cha de go re sira tel pe ja go re
So the first analogy is about this vessel, but that is upside down. So what's the problem? If our mind is like this vessel that is upside down, then there's no way to listen to the teaching because it's a mind that is outside, that is not here. There's no Dharma that can enter in that mind in the same way that there's no liquid that can enter a recipient that is upside down. So I mean, if we have a mind, if we're dreaming, wandering around the place, all around the place, of course we are not listening. So this is the first fault to avoid, distraction, mental distraction.
Ne tmati maimba sewatne ne tmati nole zatun lupa inaya zatun ko nan ronaya lonshi mrumba chago resra pe te na yi de chi jinga zo chi nem ba inaya ne kinlong ya po ma ko ba chi ne chen di nga mi khe ba dra ba thoi chi da 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 ne din di da ne so so ji bo zong ne dongwa ne xie chi da da ne din di nem ba ina ne chi de ge chi nan da ya po cha ge ma resra dan dan nga zo chi ne ya de ne xiang chu sim bi ge xie ba yin san de te ba chin bu chi cha de ge res te ba chin bu chi de le ne sen chi tan chi ge de song ji ge ton di ge long ji yo no ne go bo resra ne yin san ni ran chi bu xi de thoi chi de da ne so so khe ba de min de dra ba de thoi chi de ne din di ge ge long ton ne ba yin na ne ne ma zong an de nang yi cha de be ji ba cha ge resra
And so the second one is when the vessel is on the proper side, so liquid can go inside, but it's dirty, or smelly or dirty. Yeah. So what's the problem here? If it's about motivation, if we have an unclean motivation, impure motivation, for example, if our motivation is to become famous, to get a great reputation, or to get money, or this kind of motivation, selfish motivation, it's improper to receive the teaching. Yeah. And because here, the teaching we're going to be receiving, they are from the Mahayana, from the universal vehicle, means our motivation is to develop bodhicitta. And bodhicitta is that specific altruistic mind that wish to achieve the state of enlightenment, the state of a Buddha. for the sake of all sentient beings. So it's not about working for oneself alone, but for the sake of all sentient beings. Therefore, this is the motivation we should have at the time of listening to this teaching. Not thinking about one's own benefit, not thinking about benefit for this life, about fame, reputation, and so forth, but we should get the motivation, a Mahayanist motivation. And the third fault is like if the vessel is broken down, is leaking down. What's happening? The liquid is going inside, but is leaking, is going out, is not staying in that vessel or in that recipient. So it's the same if we are not putting attention, if we don't concentrate, if we don't keep mindfulness at the time of listening to the teaching, then we will forget everything. Nothing will stay in our mind. Whatever is said will go out directly, immediately. So this is the third fault to avoid to be distracted, to avoid not to concentrate. We should put the strong attention at the time of listening to the teaching.
And then dushi dushi ra chi la dushi chi chepa dushi
So the next point is about listening the teaching with this six kind of consideration. First, to consider our idea, six idea or consideration. First, to see oneself as someone that is very sick, seriously sick, with a illness. The second point is to see the Dharma as the medicine, the teaching as the medicine. The third point is to see the teacher, the one who taught this teaching, as the physician, as the doctor. So first one is sick, second one need the medicine, that is the Dharma. The Dharma is the medicine. Third, the physician or the doctor is the teacher. The fourth one is knowing that by applying that medicine, we will be cured. So I mean the treatment applying the treatment, that is practicing Dharma. The fifth one is to perceive, to see all the Tathagatas, the Buddhas as supreme being, supreme holy beings. And the last one is wishing that the teaching lasts for a very long time. So the first consideration is to consider oneself or to view oneself as someone that is very sick. We might say, well, I'm not sick right now. But it's not the case. If we really think about that, we can realize that we have this long-term sickness. The cause of that sickness are the three poison, the three roots, mental affliction. For example, we have this attachment, desire and attachment. Because of that, whatever we want, any object that we want, for example, if we're not getting it, we become frustrated, suffering and insatisfaction due to attachment. Also, we have anger, like a chronicle, a very strong, omnipresent anger. Due to that, like if someone just insults us a little bit, we become angry immediately. And based on that, we also have this jealousy for others, pride, and then malice, the wish to harm others, and so forth. So all this kind of negative behavior came from this, the three poison, and this is the basis of our sickness. So we said that our sickness is due to the three basic poisons of attachment, anger, and ignorance. And the third consideration is to perceive the Dharma as the medicine. Why? Because the Dharma is the exact antidote to get rid of these three poisons of attachment, anger, and ignorance. And then after knowing that, after having been given the treatment or the medicine by the teacher, then we need to apply it. Because we know well that even if we recognize, identify our sickness, even if we know that there is that specific medicine that is working, that is curing that illness, if we're not applying that medicine, if we're not taking the medicine, then there's no result. So if you want to be free from that specific sickness, we have to apply the proper treatment, which is practicing the Dharma as being taught by the teacher, the physician. So the teacher, considering the teacher, the Dharma teacher, as the physician or as the doctor, why? Because he's the one that is guiding us on the path. He's giving us the prescription. He's giving us the medicine and the advice, the instruction to apply that medicine. For example, he's telling us you have attachment, desire. This is the antidote. You have anger. You have ignorance. Those are the antidotes. So he's explaining us the way to practice, the way to apply the medicine, to apply the antidote, to get rid of our sickness. So he's giving the instruction for us to apply.
So the fifth
one is recognizing, viewing the Tathagatas, the Buddhas, as holy beings, as supreme holy beings. Why? Because they are the one who have practiced the Dharma, who have applied the medicine of the Dharma. Due to applying the Dharma as medicine, they obtain this freedom from the three basic poison of attachment, anger, ignorance, and therefore they are holy beings, sacred beings, supreme beings. And the last one, so is wishing or making prayers, wishing for the Dharma to stay long for a very long time, and also to the Buddha to abide for a very long time to give the teaching to all. And And so the proper way to listen to the teaching is, as was saying Vasubandhu, is saying your mind should be free from affliction, mental affliction. So it should be free from like more mundane or afflicted motivation, which is maybe to gain some wealth, to gain fame, to get a good reputation. So a mind that is free from this kind of mental affliction is the proper one to listen to the teaching. Mm.
And ma she goes le tikashi shina so so good ma chil sena shini ro ni chini ma she ba yimba le lo go on go shini ni shini yan chi chi al pa chi chin de me ba she ba yan go go le so so pe kale kanto shi ya chi shi de den de ma yimba ro ni chi ma she goes le ni chi pe sen ga ga jin to yin ba zung dang de ji bi go ma she go go sang go re sa.
And also we should check our mind, we should observe our mind to be sure that there is no affliction inside. For example, maybe we know little Dharma, but we are kind of greedy. We keep it for ourselves without wanting to share it with others. Or maybe we have laziness that makes us not listening to the teaching with enthusiasm. Or maybe sometimes if it's a bit hard and tired, or we feel tired, we become disheartened. And all this kind of wrong motivation or wrong mind based on the affliction, we should get freedom, we should be free from them, and we should get the opposite, which is delight, enjoying, and be delighted to listen to the teachings.
Ani maso bala meja wosani ani soso chishi ndi yoni koli chishi gwese soso ya ya shishiro chisi ya rewa maji bajile ani machi shi ado ko se juya chi do tindi gchi shi ya na ndi gmar sungo resra maso bala soa mato bala chishi ya yomar sungo resra.
And if we are impatient, also we won't go far in the teaching. Even if it's a little difficult, we should have perseverance and patience at the time of listening to the teaching.
And when
we are here to listen to the teaching, it's our own choice, isn't it? Yeah, nobody's forcing us. It's not that someone is saying you have to stay here. It's our own choice. Therefore, we should put little patience and perseverance at the time of listening to the teaching and delight.
So
those were the basic points to consider to settle a proper motivation, as shown in the Lamrim, to listen to the teaching.
So
we remember our motivation. We should have faith, conviction, and faith in the teaching, in the teacher. And not only that, the specific teaching we are receiving, they are about bodhicitta, developing the supreme altruistic mind. So we should not have selfish motivation or self-centered motivation. But we should remember when we are listening to this teaching is for the sake of all sentient beings with this motivation of bodhicitta.
And so
the teaching we're going to receive, the first part of this year, it's the beautiful text from Shantideva, Bodhisattva Charyavatara, following the deeds of the Bodhisattva. And he has been composed by Shantideva. So Geshe, I thought about telling you first a little stories about Shantideva, the composer.
Okay. Yobdele, Yogi Cochasegores, Yumdele, Jitin Anjo Meng Tubares, and Jitin Tradavachi, and the Neji Gileta Tumbares.
And I've got the name somewhere. And so, first, Shantideva was born in India, in the area that is now known as Gujarat, in the south, kind of little south, middle east of east, this side, no, east west. East, west of India. It's the state of Gujarat in the special place. I don't remember the name. And his father was a king that is called, in one text, is called Kushalavaramanamana, something like that, whatever. And other texts give another name anyway. So that was the name of the father and the mother. So a king and a queen were the father and mother. And when he was a kid, around 6 years old, he had become already someone famous in the area. It seems that he had already a special contact with Manjushri, and he was, without a special guide, he was doing his own practice on his own, and he became famous for that in his own place, yeah? 6 years old.
Yo jabo tungsa ani de mama lembo to mase gya ani jabo le chiru chi se ra je bare sra ina kron de pa me na ya ani mama to yo chi de ngo ma sum chi ani jabo shi ya khe le bare sra
and so when he was still very young, his father passed away, and his father was the king, so he was supposed to hereditate the king, to become the next king for the this small kingdom, yeah? He had no wish to do that, but he has no choice. Seems that it was his commitment to become the next king.
Ini ko sanin la ta jabo loi jabo yut chakal dia res ra deni mol ko milan tong bares milan mini ini jitin jambi yo sanin ko jabo deka jabo chati kan yu ne ini den de chat ngi res nga de sa res jitin jambi yo ko milan tong ne ini chiro ngi getu res ini yin san nga ra gegin getu ni chati kan de na ri gi ma res ya ta milan te min bares ra de min san ni ta nga jabo zun ni gi mundu te ni ini chi thol te chi ma res ka te so ma res
yes. And so then the day just before, the night before to the intronization as a king, he had this dream of, or this dream like a vision of Manjushri. And Manjushri told him, look, the throne that you're about to sit is my throne. So it's not okay for you to sit on my throne as a king. You're my disciple. So you have to get rid, to abandon that option to become the king, to sit on that throne. And you should come to study the Dharma. So finally, the next day, after waking up, he decided not to go through the intronization, not to become the king, and he escaped the kingdom.
Then he
went to Nalanda.
Nalentale ani danda pendata shivi javilhas ya dura kro gegin javilhal otle tuni ani rot shuni tabachi bares ra tini
Prajna Deva, something like that. So then he met his first teacher in Alanda, Gelwalha, in Tibetan, I think Prajna Deva, something like that, most probably the name of his first teacher in Sanskrit.
And Shivi Gocha
was his name. So in Sanskrit, I have to check. I give you the name tomorrow. He had the name before to become a monk. And then at the time of getting his monastic ordination, he became known as, he got his new name, ordination name, that is Shivalha in Tibetan, Shantideva.
And so
he stayed quite a while in Alanda, and after a while he became famous. He was named the one with the three realizations, yeah? And the three realizations were about eating, sleeping and going to the toilet, defecating. Yeah, so there were supposed to be three realizations.
Traba Mama dig Trishini, and they call it that Chihakomar Kotu, that she all like Chihakomeba Yagora, Ko Chihakomar, any truck on the Yanni, Chin, Don Deag, Remotiony, call Don Denchigina, and they call Chi Loya Mea Isan, and they call Pendogres, Tendogres, Tinsan, Chichigores, Trishibares.
And so, of course, the monks in Nalanda, they were not really happy with him. They say he's not a proper monk, he doesn't have nothing to do here. Yeah. So they wanted to kick him out of Nalanda. Because they say to stay in Nalanda, either as a monk, either you're supposed to study, or you're supposed to meditate, or you're supposed to work, or only the old monks were not in action. No? So he was not fulfilling none of these kind of activities, so they decided to kick him out. But they have to find a way, because they cannot just say it just like that, no? So they have to find a way to kick him out. So they said, well, he's not studying Dharma, he's not meditating, he's not working, he's not old. He doesn't know anything about Dharma, he doesn't know well the Dharma, so we're going to catch him here. We're going to ask him to teach Dharma, and of course he will not able to say anything, so that's the way we're going to use to kick him out of the of Nalanda.
Any call Chichiru in Don Dem, Bachiruchi Seloris, any Kiyong Mara, Shigmar Selosan, any Kotzug Uzuchini, any intimate Shigolas, any Kelembares.
And so they went to him, the monks, they went to Shantideva, they said, please teach us some Dharma. Come to the throne and teach us some Dharma. I said, no. So they asked a question, they requested again and again in very insisting way. And at the end, he accepted to teach the Dharma.
Chiwala, Nang in Tinle, Tape, Pusun Subangazare, Nang Topi Zunta the Soma Dender Chazares, Ra, in a coat Hamagoins, and it's Chiwala, Lapadic Chuck Niman Nentores, Tenma, this pony, and it Chuck on a Pepperes, Ra, Chuck on a peasant, and it Tanga Chisiade, Nima, Go Nuajin Denguga, in a Go Manumba in Dengures, Ma, Sumbares, Ra, that coats Go Manumba, Taha, Go Manumba in Dems, and Co Hakumas, and Coats Nima Mago by Kundingu, Sumaresra, Juaresia.
Yes. And so then after that, they fix a date. And at the time, when the time was coming, they do this big preparation. They convoked all the assembly, a great congregation of monks and so forth, for Shantideva to feel even more ashamed. Yeah. And they build this very high throne, and without putting stairs to go up on the throne to start. Yeah, in this way, no? And then they arrive, everybody, the big congregation is there present, there's very high throne, no stairs to go up the throne, and Shantideva arrived. And Shantideva, of course, what they didn't know, that he has special powers due to his realization on the path. So what he could do is extend his hand, put down the throne, sit on the throne, and let the throne going up again. That's it. And then suddenly everybody saw Shantideva on this high throne. They were quite amazed to start. And then he asked, which kind of Dharma do you want? Which kind of teaching do you want? Do you want a teaching that is already known? Or do you want something new? And of course they were laughing and they say, well, we want something new, because the new is more difficult, so you won't be able to give anything new. So that's what they requested, new teaching.
Mm-hmm. Tene ane ta shinju gungo tsune deshi chichi kunga si ta chi shayi kenla kipi shatsa desi ane shinju tanda shinju gungo tinma sungba resi ra. Sune ane maa shinju kepa ma lesa ni ngi tungba ta tsigyo ra. O ti tsang lele de ane kongri nankano po sung resi ra. Ane jima ya ya poni de jima zu mantong ba cha ane dra kwa de ba chi. Ane shinju chansang den ba resi ra.
And so he started what is now renowned as the Bodhisattva Charyavatara, these famous books, The Deeds of the Bodhisattva. So he started with the first words that seems to be respectfully, I pay homage to the Sugatas and so forth. And he went up to teach all the chapters up to chapter 9 somewhere, verse 34, that he's saying something when there is no more, no neither existence or non-existence or no object and no not object, absence of object present in the mind, etc. At the time of saying those words, verse 34, if you want to check in the chapter 9, at the time that he was saying those words, he just went up in the sky, he went flying in the sky and disappeared, and only the sound of his voice could be heard. So all the end of the chapter 9 and chapter 10 were only listened by a few people without him, without his presence.
Any Jumata can in the Tatig orderly, the Tidele, Lopa Kinitim by Yon 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 the Tower, Gresti Tayon, Reshin Dodin, and Dodikinitiba Tasia, Shinju no Tigiresra. That take Karaina Seada, Kotzahakoga Maresra, Lopa Kintisia, and Dodikintin, Jun Karimba, Hamagobachira, and Tinish Shunsani, and a Juma, and a Kotzakoyale, and a Shuala, that Loshu Jaga Loshu and Dusia, the Kotzkoares. The koi ko sir giluni tani ni shiwala dende shuka tani sirah ya peru chise ni. Nasa ni shiwala ya peru chiva mare sirah peru majiba chi. Ani shinju ge yung leu de yu ije penda ge zunga nongji leu chu shiba de yin sirah yung chi dega res. Ani nodde kine tiba de lopa kine tiba ni ani karan ni sa ge ni hang ge ani jang ge duma pala le yi ge chun chun chini ya yo sunga res sirah. Ani yel te mare.
Okay, yeah. And so there's at that time there were some great pandits that have amazing memory. They have this capacity of retention, song retention, that's not forgetting anything of the words. So later on they could take notes, transcribe this teaching of Shantideva. And then after a while there was a debate. Some scholars from Kashmir were saying there's only 9 chapters. And some other scholar from Magadha, I think, were saying there's 10 chapters actually. So there was this question. And then there was another question that arose that Shantideva a few times mentioned two other texts. One is a compendium of training, the other is a compendium of the sutras, Shiksha Samukaya, and the other was Sutra Samukaya. And so he mentioned these two texts, but nobody knew about those two texts. It's a fact because Shantideva himself has composed them, but they were not known to nobody. So therefore there was these two questions about 9 or 10 chapters and about which texts are these two texts, compendium of training and compendium of sutra. So then after, later on, the scholars from Nalanda went in search to Shantideva. They went searching for him. And actually they found him in South India. And they requested him to come back to Nalanda to teach again that precious text. And he did not accept. He did not accept to go. But he told them, actually the scholar from Magadha are correct. There are 10 chapters with specific numbers of verses. And those two texts, the compendium of training and compendium of sutras, you can find them in my old room in Alandai. They are on a beam on the ceiling, something like that. So you can find these two texts that I composed before. And so that was the end of this story.
Momboji le any taco nombal at Saint Juyaga shown a pento yobaji dazini any muteba adjatsanji tendaji nin sajajil any kuri tin nan the peppers ra pesani de tipakojile any mugeshu kala marabachi kangi trick tendashiusan that muteba kotso mende trishini any ngazo that so sotoyaga kala sotoyaji pembola kini and jima tig karelona tig kal nyingi in sea the kotsi yores this is any shiwala zuntu yaisan nje longzi kangchi ge ani ya xinle xini ani mo de ba meng ajia ci chang song pe zhu gu jia tu ba zi an de xue de sira de ko bian bo le ki de ki san ne chong ma nang ba zi ju a de sira go de sira
and it's not the end of the story actually because there's a few more things coming after. He was living in India and South India and different parts, and he was his magical powers were really amazing, and his motivation, of course, was to work for sentient beings. So whatever sentient being might need, he was helping in any way possible. Yeah. So for example, at one point he met with a wrathful group of Tirthika, non-Buddhist philosopher. And he could he entered in big debate with them, and he gained victory on the debate. He defeated them, and they had to become Buddhist. Another story is that at one point there was like a very hunger. People were suffering from hunger, not enough food, and so forth. And so again, he used his magical power. So he had a bowl of rice, and he multiplied it, and with that he could feed 500 hungry people. And being convinced by his powers, then they also became Buddhist and practiced the path.
Ani kubchile ani peche shashu insa yo jagarwa ani ambitious ani yo jabojile. Ti kosi yun yamba le pe kange shun lo swale. Ti esani mat chamba ta japan na bombo ji yo jabotele sajale. Ani jaboti ke chamba ti odele kalate yapo shia ina ne. Ta ko mat ducha ti odele an tinde shia ina soso jabo ke onchan na bode te zunga ke kochi ke munza. Yapo maji ba ina ta ti odi koron sili ke jabo siya ke nengha shi tu resra. Tinde kosi le ani shiwa la ke ani tele pe ni ani shiwa la ke ani ki ke churong sungsho ngishi chu siya kelen ba resra. And then Sunsho Yaposhi, she was like Zijig, Zunsho, Sunsuma, Kusuma, Oshini, and then Jabodi Kusuma Shini, and then Chirikos, and then Theod Matisan, that call it Chiwala Tencha, Shing, Trijimikoya, Maresra, Tushin, Shinjig. That Tropo digger, Tako Ropa digger, the Shin Trim Hakores, Hakosan, any Jabodele Tako Mente, Yochin Rendu, Yojiji Rendu, Sra, Jabole, Traduchin, that Jabol
learning,
Metiga, Koro Shiwala, Ropa digger, Kusuma digger. Call a shing trigimato mendu, and a jabo sunsho shis yade, where call yoji zimar in duce lores, the jabo controlani, and the alon the chirong, treadingal meeting goes lores, the loina, and the shuala, and a tree yatin, your marima tree yatina, jabo churon nishin yungres, ra. The lopanis and jabo, and a tingur, and al tingus udujabares, udujas and the shual cassic tinguguyona, and a churon mikad makos, ya mi yatira, makoni tis sooner, ne, and a tredia shunia tinson.
And it's not the end. There's another story about Shantideva later on. He was seems to be most probably in the east of India, and there was a king called Ambisha, something like that. And he was he was very good king, and he was in danger. He was in danger to be attacked by another king, another kingdom, and there was problem that he was to lose his place and so forth, and to be killed and so forth. So it was quite dangerous. And Shantideva decided to help him, so to become his bodyguard. He became the bodyguard of the king, and he started to protect the king against the invader and so forth. And the only weapon that he had to work as or to protect the king was a sword, but this sword was in wood, like a stick of wood that he was using as a sword. Yeah, but it was hidden in a cover, kind of cupboard, you say in English, something like that, the cover. Yeah, and so there was someone who was in the entourage of the king, and someone who was jealous. And so that person went to the king, talked with the king, saying, "Your new bodyguard is complete, is fake. He has no power to protect you. His sword is a stick of wood." Yeah. And so this person was very perseverant in accusing Shantideva and talking about Shantideva in this way. So at one point, the king became like a bit frustrated, and he wanted to check, maybe more than a bit, I'm not sure. Angry, they say. And so he wanted to check if he was real or not, yeah? And so he asked Shantideva, "Please show me your sword that is supposed to protect me." And Shantideva said, "I cannot show you that sword because it's going to harm you, hurt you." Yeah? And the king insisted again and again, "I want to see the sword that is supposed to protect me." So Shantideva said, "Okay, but you have to block at least one, to protect one eye. And you will look with only one eye." Okay? and I will show you my sword. So when the king was like protecting one eye, so Shantideva took the sword out of his cupboard, and it was full of light. It was a sword of full of light, a light so intense that it blinded the other eye of the king. Yeah. And so the king get complete faith in the power of Shantideva after seeing that.
That Jesus, Mateba, Shankan Devasia, the Mateba Kepashi, the Matashiro Matebara, Yotele, and it digs in Nomba, Zepatigins, Zepatigo, Jabo Pombo unit, Zepatini, Cassi, Nomba Ponson, Nomba Thomas, Mateba, said Jugos, and it Cassi Cots, Mateba Ponsonina, and Nomba Padua, the Jen Jani, Tuni, and it Zepatigos, Loris, Ra, Jabo the Nombares. In there, that Mateba, let Zepati to a Gimba Chin, Nomba Kepatana, Mara, Jabo be sent him. She had the best Senpahi, the Kosele, and it Yomodiga, and it Kigu teach Mashi Kosele, and Tendaji Metanagin Dusra, Chikon, Chigucho, Kombal Po, and Pe Chuyutsma Kyutan, and Majitonson said, and Jabodigan could take a juice, Lordes. And Yomod Tekandosan, and it the Shiwala Tubares, and Shiwala Dendishuni, and it the Matabatigulas, and Shiwala, and then Rigres, and it Pumbaji, Pumbachu Kanshi.
Another story. So that time it was seems to be in the south of India. So Shantideva was a beggar or something like that, was not an ordinary person, seems to be in this kingdom. And when the queen one day was going on the road, something, she saw that whatever drops of water that were falling on the skin of Shantideva, of that person, became boiling water immediately, was starting to boil. Yes, it's something that is not common. So she noticed that specific thing of that beggar. And so she went back home. And the king was in trouble because there was another Tirthika, another non-Buddhist, powerful yogi. And he said, I will destroy your faith in the Dharma, in the Buddhism. You will have to get faith in my teaching. And to obtain that, what I will going to do is to draw a mandala of a special Hindu deity, or to draw a mandala of the secret world of that deity in the sky. Yeah, and whoever has no faith in me will be destroyed. So there was a big danger now. And the queen reported to the king, say, you know what I saw today? I saw that person on the street, and I saw that he had the power of make the water boil as soon as this was falling on his skin. So that might be a great, powerful being. So they call upon Shantideva, and Shantideva accepted to come to see the king. The king explained the situation, the danger that they were going through. And Shantideva said, okay, I will come tomorrow when this Tirthika yogi will start to draw the mandala, I will be here. Bring me a pot, a recipient, bring me a piece of cloth, and bring me some fire. And tomorrow I will be here.
That in the Shikos, any Muteba Shankan Devasiadiga, and Tigger, any Zontokutone, any Onshu Chinkos, any Panang Tumbale, Onshu Chinkos, Trivaris, Ra. Trini, any shago by the goat by the art, some are Tusan, any Jasishima Shiwalaga, any Sepa Lung thing in the set, Lung Gunga thing in the uni, any Lung Chambotani, any pe, take it at Somato, only you look to go back to combat some Mombo Toshin Shimares, Ra, and Tindishu goes, any Jabo the Jamotio, Ninsan, Wage Jenny, any Jabo the Jamotio, Sajatoma, any the Kungrig Shuani, any pe or
Mm-hmm. And so the second part of the story is like that. So the next day, this Tirtika came, and he started to draw this this world of it might be Ishvara, one of the Hindu deities. No? So he started to draw the mandala in the sky, and he started with the eastern side of the mandala. And he did not have time to finish, to do the complete drawing of the mandala. He just started with the east, and Shantideva immediately destroyed it. So he's done that due to the power of his concentration. It just make a rise, a very strong wind, hurricane, something like that, yeah, that destroyed completely the east side of the mandala and destroyed completely everything. So then the Tirtika was kind of neutralized. And because of the strength of this strong wind, then the sun disappeared. It was full of dust and dirt in the sky, and it became completely dark. So nobody saw anything. And next, Shantideva saw the king and the queen and their entourage in the darkness. They were completely lost. And due to the wind, they lost also their clothes. They were naked, dirty, and lost in the darkness. So Shantideva produced a ray of light coming from between the two eyes, in the eyebrow here, and giving with this light, he guided the king and the queen. And he brought them close to the recipient where there was water to clean them. And then he put them the clothes that he asked them to bring at the beginning. And then he put them near the fire and so forth. So they were protected, and nothing happened to the kingdom finally.
Ini ngaco telu lebih lengko ya kerja urusan ni lah, tiga logik tu ni lah. Ini ngaco mesin le, pat sila kau ni ngaco nanti nongi ke mana sih daya mebat tapi kecik murid imbat tak tinggal urusan lah. Mere parol le, kau nanti inten kandai ya mende ngaco sisi hak kau tu gua marus lah. Silo gua mesti sih sultan ni mere sih je sih ada sih ada juga tapi tu sih na tak rigi mebat ngaco tini lebih lengko urusan lah. So so nong le zuci tu ada. Nemo mati ya tadi si kau sana tunggal me, me jembar le sini sini mal tadi si dia tu, tetapi tak menjadi me pada loya terus lah, so nengko.
And so what's the point about saying all these stories, and so what's the moral we can get from these stories about Shantideva? Basically, is that we should not look down at nobody, we should not judge others because we don't know, we cannot see actually the capacity or the qualities of others, yeah. Therefore, we should treat everybody with equal respect. Well, because due to our distorted mind, then we perceive all kind of things that are not real, and due to our ignorance, we don't see the reality. So we don't see who is who exactly. So that's why we should always respect everybody and not look down to no one.
Anyone? Tak siapa lagi login dapat di disini tenderi sera, entah aso ni ke yang de gol mat den rot nasera, yang juga gol mat.
So this is that was a brief introduction, say Geshe La, about the motivation and the story of the composer Shantideva, composer of that text. So we're gonna start with the beginning.
Ina aso de tak ni ke siapa ke yang juga mat zawa kita, lewa de ane jasa rumah cik sumbar sera.
And so the text we're going to see, of course, the root text, Shantideva, Bodhisattva Charyavatara, but we're going to go also through a commentary that has been written by Gyeltsen. And he was one of the main disciple, or the main disciple of Lama Jetson Kapa.
So
Geshe is saying, well, this commentary is quite big, yeah. And so we have limited time to go through this topic on Shantideva. So Geshe La is proposing to go through, of course, all the words of the root text of Shantideva, the Bodhisattva Charyavatara. But about the commentary, is going to just extract the essential parts, the essential point that we should know, without going through the whole commentary of Gyeltsen. So usually the nice way to study the text is going through what is called in Tibetan the sachi or the outlines. This is something that the Indian pandits or the Indian scholars and were not using these outlines. This is something that had been made in Tibet. Yeah, so from Tibet, all the scholars in Tibet, not all, but most of them, when they compose using these outlines. And the point about the outlines that is showing the kind of the skeleton or the general map of the teaching, so it's good to consider to have the outlines with us, then we can contemplate on the essential part of the teaching and knowing the step-by-step how to use this teaching or how to study this teaching. So usually the outlines are divided into three. First is the title, and that's going to explain the meaning of the title. Next is the body of the text itself. And finally is the dedication. So usually the texts are divided into these three main points: the title, the body of the text, or the text itself, and the dedication, the conclusion. So first we start with the title. So the title in Sanskrit is called the Bodhisattva Charyavatara. In Tibetan is called the Janchu Sempe Chöpalajupa. And in English it's called Engaging in the Bodhisattva Deeds. So the title is Bodhisattva Charyavatara is saying Janchu is for body. So Janchu is enlightenment. Sempa is a heroic being or hero. So Janchu Sempa is referring to a bodhisattva. And so bodhisattva in the Bodhisattva Charyavatara in the title. Next is saying Chöpa. Chöpa, it's about the conduct or the deeds or the action to be performed or the behavior. And Jukpa. Jukpa is to engage in, to enter in or to engage in something. So literally will be to engage in the conduct of the bodhisattva, of the great hero to enlightenment. Yeah, and the title is just showing what's the main topic of that text, the main subject of that text. And there is also one part that is mentioned that is actually the translator homage. That is not something that was mentioned by Shantideva himself, but is the translator homage, the one who was translating into Tibetan.
Okay.
And also the translator is mentioning something specific here, is a specific number of stanza of the text to be sure that at the time of translating or at the time of getting access to that text in Tibet, that there was nothing that would be added to the text or nothing that would be missing from the text. So for that, they have a specific measurement of the how many stanza exactly are in the text. So this measurement is called Pangpo and in Tibetan, and it can be special numbers of lines or stanza. It can be, for example, 25 or 300, but usually it's a fixed number depending on the text. So, for example, when we speak about the Yom, the Prajnaparamita Sutras, there are different of them. The greatest one, the long one, the extensive one is 100,000 stanzas, for example, etc. When we speak about the Heart Sutra, it's about 23 stanzas. So there's a specific number to the text. And now, next is I pay homage. So I pay homage to all the Buddhas and Bodhisattvas. That that line is not composed, has not been written by Shantideva, but has been written by the translator from Sanskrit to Tibetan. I pay homage to all Buddhas and Bodhisattvas. And so first there is an homage from the translator, and next there's the commitment of there's the homage of the text, and next there is this words of commitment saying I will compose this text. The purpose to put that little words at the beginning of a composition is like to take a commitment to be sure that the one who's starting to compose the text will complete his task, will go up to the end of the composition of the text. That's why at the beginning, usually, after the few words of homage, there is this commitment, I will recompose this text, whatever, to be sure that it's going through all the process up to the end. So the translator, there was this rule that was established for the Tibetan Lhotse, or the translators when they were to translate text from the Sanskrit, that they should, by adding this verse of homage, they should show which of the three pitaka, or the three baskets, was pertinating that text in Sanskrit. The teachings of the Buddha has been split into three main categories, what we call the three baskets or the pitaka. So the first is the sutra pitaka, the basket of the sutras. And for that, the verse added by this Tibetan translator is, I pay homage to Buddhas and Bodhisattvas, which is the case here. So we know that the text of Shantideva is included in that first category of the first basket, the basket of the sutras, a sutra pitaka. The second one is Vinaya pitaka. So the basket of the Vinayas, the rules, monastic rules, and so forth. So for that, when someone was translating this kind of text into Tibetan, he was to add this homage, specific homage, to omniscience, the mind of a Buddha, of Buddha Shakyamuni. Yeah? So homage to omniscience is showing that that text is coming from the Pitaka, from the basket of the Vinaya. And the last basket is the Abhidharma, Abhidharma Pitaka, so the basket of the Abhidharma text on what you called object of knowledge in general, Abhidharma, I check. And so for that, the homage is given to Manjushri. Homage to Manjushri was the little homage added by the Tibetan translator. So cosmology and phenomenology. This is what is mean, what means Abhidharma. So those are the three Pitaka, the three basket, basket of the Sutra, of the Vinaya, and the Abhidharma. And the three kind of homage, either it's homage to the Buddha's Bodhisattva, or it's homage to omniscience, homage of the Buddha, the mind of the Buddha, or it's homage to Manjushri, and these are the homage added by the Tibetan translator. And of course, so usually also it's related to the three highest training, the training in ethic, the training in concentration, and the training in wisdom. So in relation to the training of ethic, is corresponding with the Vinaya Pitaka, with the basket of the Vinaya. The training in the wisdom, referring to the wisdom, knowing, emptiness, and so forth, usually is related to the basket of the Abhidharma. And here, the basket of the sutra is related with the highest training in concentration. So the, all this part that we were mentioning here is the preliminary of the first words, introduction words given by the composer of the commentary, and in relation to the translator. And next, when after seeing that, then we go directly to the words of Shantideva, so directly to the root text. And the words of Shantideva are starting with, respectfully, I pay homage to the Sugatas who are endowed with the Dharmakaya, as well as to their children and to all who are worthy of homage. You have the text with you, no? Most of you?
Yeah.
And so Shantideva starts with his own words of homage and commitment and so forth. So here actually the reason to start with what is called in Tibetan the chuju, or this specific homage, is there is three reasons. First, to guarantee that this teaching are holy teaching, yeah, correct holy teaching. Second is for the sake of getting rid of any obstacle, hindrances at the time of composing a text or teaching. And the third reason is the final goal that is actually to achieve the state of a Buddha, to achieve full enlightenment. So for these three points, so one starts with this specific homage.
So, actually,
what's the need? What's the purpose to do this homage? Is first to develop for the listener or for the one who's going to read that text to build up for that person kind of reliance or trust trust into the text, therefore trust into the composer. So first is to mention the aspect of the holy teaching and the holy person that's composing the teaching for the sake of, for that purpose, for the listener to trust or to rely, to have confidence in the teaching that are taught here. And if the person who's going to listen to that teaching or read that teaching, if he has trust and confidence on the composer and on the teaching, then great qualities or great benefit will come from getting access to that teaching. So we're going to get a little break here, 15 minutes maybe. No sé, vamos a ver. Cada día sentarme, no. No sentarme cada día con él. A veces ver algo.
Porque antes, cuando era que se necesitaba el texto, cuando se encontraban, yo me unía a ellos, nada más que para estar un poquito en el baño, así que no sé si...
No, difícil, porque vamos pum, 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 así, ¿no? Y ayer fue 5 minutos y listo, y la semana próxima vamos a ver.
Claro, son 5 minutos acá y allá, no haces nada más que eso.
No,
claro,
sí, no. Sí.
Bueno, está, vine a preguntar.
Sí, por acaso.
Claro,
Pero si no creo. Apenas entré en el texto, vamos a chichar. Apenas entré en el texto, vamos a ir así nomás, supongo.
Now that it is short,
So in terms of the homage, when we're saying there's 3 points to put the homage at the compose, the homage at the beginning, Gyeltsen in the commentary as well as Shantideva here, both of them are starting with the homage. One of the points is to get rid of the obstacle for the composition. Why? Because by composing that text, you accumulate virtues or merits, and this virtue is the antidote to diminish or to destroy the non-virtue. So that's the essential part about starting with the homage, to get rid of the obstacles and to accumulate merit, to remember that the composition of the text is a good way to accumulate merits.
Mm-hmm. Any Tinchi Zumba Pachi Shia Insan, Teletini, any Pachi Shia, any Soso Zumba Tashimbala, any Tinchi Pecha Shanchu Senda, any Tuni to be sure to other, the Jija Shia Insan, the Jija La Comba Shibalatini, the Og J Shanchu Senda Tum to be Tawa Ranji La Shia, Teletini, any Tata Nemo, the Shiji Diba Mariba Puin, Nile, and Godin Tabatabala, Rani Chantoshi, Yen Duja, Tinchi Zumba Tashi, and Tinchi La Tisanjinju.
And also Geshe mentioned that the final goal is to achieve complete enlightenment, the state of a Buddha. Yeah? So that's the final motivation, we can say, for this homage, paying homage at the beginning of the composition, for the sake of ultimately achieving enlightenment. How does it work? Means that by getting rid of the obstacle, one can perform the task, accumulating virtue in that way, and based on virtue, one will go through the different stages of the path. So one will develop bodhicitta, one will realize emptiness, and those two are the essential point treated or topics of this text. Yeah, and there are also the goal to develop bodhicitta and to realize emptiness. Based on that, one will be able to destroy the afflictive emotion, the affliction, while one will be able to experience or to achieve true cessation, to actualize true cessation, and so forth, up to achieving finally the state of a Buddha. So that's the way it's working.
Devi Gulang, Shanchu Gusenda, Tuni to be children, Tela Lang Latini, Devi Compont Tasemba Ship by Insani, and it Deva Shibasera.
And sorry, so the words of Shantideva, the first verse, is saying, respectfully, I pay homage to the Sugatas, who are, and so forth. So Sugatas, is Dewa Shekpa in Tibetan. It's an epithet for Buddhas. And Dewa Shekpa is the one gone beyond, gone to bliss. Dewa is bliss, Shekpa is to gone, the one who has gone to the bliss state, we can say. So why is it like that? It's referring to the fact that by developing bodhicitta, by realizing emptiness, so with the two, bodhicitta and wisdom, then one can achieve that state of supreme happiness. So that's the meaning of this word, Sugata, gone to bliss. Epithet for Buddha.
Any Dewa Shepa said, Shits, Yadig, Shits, any Mazo Shitang, Goding, Intel, Yawajida, any Nanching, Topi, Intel, Yaw, Ninton, Shits, Yoresra, Goding, Intel, Yaw, and Shits, Yadle, Godi, Shepa, Sunda, Dema, Lepa Shepa, Madoba Shepa, Maliba Shepa, any Shepa Sundingon, Shigoresra.
And so gone to bliss, Dewa is bliss, Shekpa, gone, the one gone at that point. What does it mean? The one that achieved the state of omniscience, and previously to that is the one who has achieved, who actualized true cessation, so the perfect knowledge. So it's referring to the quality of the realization, yeah? That has three aspects, this quality has three aspects. First is perfect, yeah, a perfect quality of true cessation. Second is irreversible, there's no way to reverse it. And third is complete without nothing left behind.
Tinsani, Tig Chepa Careton Papa Tingosena, Lepa Shepa, Siadi, Shirobi, Santi, Nijito, Dil, Tiole, Labad, Ra, Tingores. Any Madoba Shepa, any Jinju Ninti, Jinju Lasova, Ninti Papa, Jinju Las, the Shun Tiodil, Labad, Tingores, Ra, Maliba Pomba Shepa, Siadi, Dachumbi, Ninti Dachumba Tiodil, Labad, Tingores, Ra.
And why is it so? So why there are these three, or what these three characteristics, what is referring to? First, the fact that is a perfect true cessation or perfect realization of the truth, it's because it's beyond, it's much higher than the knowledge or the wisdom of a non-Buddhist, Chirolpa, of a non-Buddhist philosopher, for example. Next, it's said to be irreversible. Why irreversible? Because it's showing that it's higher than the kind of realization obtained by a Shravaka, a Pratika Buddha, the practitioner on the Hinayana vehicle. And thirdly, it's complete, without an exception, it's complete. This is referring to the fact that that realization is highest than an arhat, a foe destroyer of the Hinayana level.
Any Shiroba Teo de Lepashipa Mayim Junsen Karesenara, any Santi Nijitio Teo de la Shiroba Teo, any Nipin Nemon Lasuba, Ninjua Pongores, Hina Sabin Pontugo Maris, Ra, Tinsani, any Lepashipa Sia Chagio Maris, any Shun Teo Shun the Jinju Teo Ninti Papa Teo de, any Madoba Shipa Sia Maris, Karesena, call Yonjak Kuala Lion Shiva Lingua Isan, Kuala Lamaduba de Maris, Yonja Shiva Lingua Isan. Ani madoba shiba chagyo mares. Ani ninti drachomba tiyo maliba shiba mayin bi junsen karesena. Ani kozo shidri pontu ya mares. Nidri poncha shidri pon matong ayinsan. Ani maliba shiba siya chagyo mares. Da teji shiba siya da tetsu tsuma da deba ayinsan. Ani chepa pomba chepa sunden siya chagyo res.
And so the first one, we're speaking about the perfect aspect of that realization that is higher than a non-Buddhist. Yeah, why? Because a non-Buddhist might be able to abandon the grosser level of delusion such as attachment, but he cannot abandon completely delusion and or affliction, sorry, and their deeds, and their seeds. Yeah, he cannot abandon completely all affliction and their seeds. The second aspect that is irreversible, it's better than the level of an Arya, Shravaka, or Pratika Buddha. Here we're speaking about Arya level, yes, the superior being of the Shravaka and Pratika Buddha, Hinayana vehicle. So the problem with them is that it's not irreversible, their realizations are not irreversible. Why? Because they are still reborn in samsara. Yeah, the Arya one, the noble being, because they're still reborn in samsara, therefore their realization is not irreversible. And the last one is said that the realization of a Sugata is complete, without no exception. Why? Because he has abandoned everything that has to be abandoned. Why? When we speak about an Arhat of the Hinayana level, a four destroyer of the Hinayana level, he has abandoned what's called afflictive obstruction, the obstruction to liberation, but they still have one obstruction left, not abandoned yet, which is called the obstruction to omniscience, or cognitive obstruction is two ways to translate it. That has not been abandoned by an arhat, but a foe destroyer of the Hinayana level. Therefore, it's not complete. While for a Buddha, Sugata, or a Buddha, he has a perfect... perfect abandonment, perfect realization, perfect abandonment, because he has abandoned not only the grosser level of delusion of a non-Buddhist, not only he has abandoned the basic level of an Arya, but he has also abandoned the two obstruction to liberation and obstruction to omniscience. So he has a full, complete realization that has abandoned all, everything, it's irreversible, it's perfect, and it's complete. Three aspects.
Ani, dah adale pa topi ini dia London ni jauh ina, lah. Nanti dia siapa ina? Ani, dah mesti engsun tu cemba, cemba temba, maliba cemba saja, cemba ini dia sunden tu sih gaul, lah.
Tampol
le, dah mesti engsun tu cemba.
Engsun.
Cemba, ani cemba temba,
Malupa. Okay. And so here we're speaking about the specific realization of abandonment, the qualities of the abandonment of the sugata. Yeah? Now we're going to speak about the positive realization that is achieved. So a sugata is perfect in the sense that he has achieved the direct realization of emptiness, that is completely firm and stable, and that is also complete without exception.
Ani tande chepa do pasa de tange kanza son de rares hero bada ani ninti jinju de shingun da ani rajam bati ora ani hero bati ode dame ning son de chemba la phalan to goin sa ko dame ning son de to ma thu ain sa ni ani tele phaba tenge ores ani shingun shingun da da lin chi shingun da da ti ode jinju ti ode te chembo tembo cha to ma res ko ala yonja la do goin sa ni ra te ma cha da mali pa chemba sa di lo chi ge dame ni demba ni la so ngun son de chemba de ta chemba de ani san
It's the same, the three qualities are shown in comparison with the same beings or practitioner that we've seen before. First, comparing with a non-Buddhist practitioner. So here we were saying before that he has a highest level of realization of the object of abandonment, or he has abandoned a higher level. Here is the same in terms of realization. Its realization is higher than a non-Buddhist because he has the direct realization of emptiness. Yeah. And second, his realization are higher than an arya, that is, for example, a stream enterer, yeah, on the Hinayana level, stream enterer and so forth, is higher because the sugata has no, is not circling, is not being reborn again in samsara in the future, while an arya, a stream enterer and so forth, they are still to be reborn in samsara again, which is not the case of a sugata. Therefore, his realization is said to be completely stable, firm, steady, of stable because of that, no? Because he's not coming back, being reborn again in samsara. And the third is in comparison with an arhat of the Hinayana level, so a four destroyer of the Hinayana fundamental level, vehicle, its sugata is higher in realization, because for the same reason, because he has abandoned completely the two obstructions, not only the obstruction to liberation, but also the obstruction to omniscience, the cognitive one, therefore it's complete, its realization is complete without exception, nothing left behind. And so the text is saying, respectfully, I pay homage to the Sugatas who are endowed with the Dharmakaya. So here we mentioned a Buddha that has completed the true cessation, the true path. So it's part of the three jewels here, yeah? Because he has the true Dharma, true cessation and true path. And next he's saying, I also pay homage to his children, to their children, the children of the Buddhas, the children of the Sugatas. This is referring to the Bodhisattva. A Bodhisattva is called a child of the Buddha. Yeah? So he's paying homage to the Buddhas and to the Bodhisattvas.
Sitanti, Shai Kinla, Kipi Shashizani, that dead on the Kincho Sombo de Mazi, Ran, that Jasichimushala Kronga, any Tailamada, any Geshe in Theodele, Shasha, Yipi, Yosomali, any Shatsi, Yisia, the Shatsi, Shasia, the Kiyo, Kindipui, the Resra, Sasia, the Pui, Koalchi, any Kipa Kindipui, Yisia, or Resra.
And so he's saying, and to all who are worthy of homage. Here I'm reading the root text of Shantideva, correct? It's not the commentary, it's the root text of Shantideva, yeah? So this is the first part of the first verse. So here what he's saying, I pay homage to the Buddha, to the Bodhisattva, so pay homage to the three jewels, and not only that, also to others who are worthy of homage, means to my root guru, and also to all my gurus and to all my teachers as well, I pay homage. And here, homage means, it can be translated also as prostration, or bowing down, or making homage. So that's the meaning, to show respect to that person.
ene shantsa te se ta peke no le te se jorra te lachi se ni oma chen yan renge yores sha yi kin la ki pi shantsa te se no chi lamat tamat te no te lachi ngde se ene kar se nga cho ka san ni lapa tro ni khala sa ge se ta tin ra bo re se ra ene ke te yo dal shantsa ni ene kare shi gin se na ene ta pe cha chung gin se ya do ene zumba tan cha de odia
And yeah, in Tibetan, there's this little sound I did at the end of the so te. I pay homage, and then there's a te. This te is kind of a speech filler, or it's a connecting word. It's saying not only that there's something coming next, and what's coming next is the promise or the commitment of composition. Yeah. So this little te in Tibetan that we don't have in English is showing that it's not finished. It's not the end. It's only the beginning. So that is the connection.
That in ego the tidiga any can give it chance at this and the shit don't and you pan say that jeja thing or is rah. On a touch of pecha tsungina, pecha can read tsung, jeja carri tsung, and Jesse Shanchu Sambananji, and shepa de shepa shawa shit on the and shanchu say nanson lent on the do shin paro chin batula lots of your conduct you gummy, not your Jesse Shepa to Jeja Shin Tsung in Sego is rah.
And the next part in the Tibetan is referring actually to the topic or the subject that's going to be treated here. So he's saying, referring to the Bodhisattva, so he's saying, I will be teaching. The meaning of that is, sorry, I will be teaching bodhicitta, and then I will be teaching the way of the practice of a Bodhisattva, the six perfection, and so forth. So this is said as, here I shall describe how to engage in the vows of the Sugata's children. So this is implying bodhicitta, six perfection, and practices of the bodhisattva. And so next, so then the opponent might say, someone might question, Shantideva say, okay, well, so you're going to say something new here? And he's saying, of course, no, I'm not inventing anything. I'm not going to imagine or invent anything. I'm just going to compose something in accordance with the words of the Buddha.
And therefore,
so the opponent will answer, well, there's no need. If already Buddha taught the teaching, so there's no need to repeat that, isn't it? And then Shantideva is saying, well, it's not the case because the teaching of the Buddha is so broad, so vast, yeah, and some are very difficult to understand. So I'm going to do it in a summarized, in a brief way that is easy to understand.
And so
here we are in the part that is this is the commitment, the composition, commitment of the composition. So where Shantideva is committing himself to complete the task. So that's the point to add this little part in the homage is to be sure that he will complete the task, that he will go up to the end, that he won't throw it away or leave it in between, in the middle. Yeah. So that's the purpose of adding these little words.
That you would learn any carsen, Hinchi, my young pion, the jimmy, dejo cap on a dollar, your mintes, your titi, any kinshum basini, and so so ma, tanga hakogame, shidashi, shigime, say, at my kinshum big resera.
And so we have gone through where we were, huh? The meaning of which I have summarized in accordance with the scriptures, we've seen that. Next, there is nothing here that has not appeared in the past, and I have no skill in the art of rhetoric. Therefore, not to enact the welfare of others, I composed this in order to acquaint it with my own, to my own mind. So he's saying here, I don't know so much, but I'm going to use it for my own sake, for my own learning process.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
And so here he's saying, first, there is nothing here that has not appeared in the past. So he's saying, I'm not inventing anything, I'm just taking things who have already been said. And next he's saying, I have no skill in the art of rhetoric. So he's saying, I'm not pretending that I'm going to do a beautiful composition
here.
And then next, so he's giving 2 points already, saying I'm not inventing anything, I'm not going to tell anything new, say anything new. Next, he's saying I'm not going to do a beautiful piece of art or rhetoric. And next, he's also saying, therefore, not to enact the welfare of others, I compose this in order to acquaint it to my mind. So he's saying here, I'm not doing for the sake of others, but I'm doing it for myself to become familiarized or to become to train myself in bodhicitta and in the wisdom realizing emptiness.
Ani tangi deshi yende sambawa dala me siyade ani korona yele pinto chini yungu marisan siya ti koya maris ra ani yende zoshi ne zongu me sira ani zongu me koya re mato ngale yele pinto chini yungu maris siya ti zongu mare ole yende samba yopa do on tingi re sira.
And here we might be confused when he's saying, "I'm not enact the welfare of others." So the purpose is not to benefit others. So we might question that, of course. So it's not the point. The point, of course, all the text is about benefiting others. The motivation of the practice that is for the sake of others. So there's no contradiction here. It's just a way to say it in a humbling way to express himself.
And
Also, there's another way to understand this little sentence, saying I'm not benefiting others in the sense that actually there's very few people that are really interested in the topic of developing bodhicitta and developing the wisdom of emptiness. Therefore, that's another way to say it here, saying I cannot benefit others because there's not so many people who are interested in bodhicitta and wisdom. Mm-hmm.
So
the fact is that in the actuality, he was speaking about Shantideva, most of the people are or were interested in only this life. Their main motivation was based on this life only, and all kind of negativities was coming from that, killing and so forth. So very, very few people were going behind this kind of mundane motivation and were thinking to develop bodhicitta.
chirang ge gon chong me churu ha kog ya na ani pecha chong go ya mende so so lo yi le yo ayina ani pecha thol chong go ya giba mendu asela na yete yo re sro pecha chong ala ji pa shi san no ton ni pecha chong go re ti insan ni shang chu gu sen da tu ni to bi ta wa la sme ti yo ani jasi ki pa te wal de ani ji pa shi san no ton chong go ani so so ge nga ge yi le shi de yo te de gomba gumphe den ro ya de da ani ti nga ma shi ba sa te chi wa ge san no ton ge ji pa yo insan ani so so gi la de ya gumphe ro chi de chong ba insa te lo go re sro.
And also he's saying, well, the other, the opponent might say, well, if you know already these things, what's the point about talking about it more again? And Shantideva is thinking, saying, well, actually, we need to contemplate on those topics again and again and again. So the purpose of composing this text is about, for the sake of contemplation, for the sake of training my own mind in those specific topic of bodhicitta and wisdom. So this is kind of giving instruction to improve my own realization or my own development of bodhicitta and wisdom.
Ani gawa gonshik da ke tipi shu nda da ke chen reshi penjula asyadi chi thama nindi karlova sena ani tindi ke shanchu gusena tuni tabashala gawa tiyode ani soso gila gombi shedan ra ani soso shanchu gusena tepa hachang chenpo yoye nisani ani pecha tsongala chua pya ra gawa pya gawa gonshik da ke tipi shu nda da ke chen reshi pen o tindi ke chua pya yunga ani nga pecha tsongin tepa di shung sung se ra pecha de
And the next, the third verse is saying, for due to acquaintance with virtue, the force of my faith will, for the time being, increase because of this. So here he's saying, by the virtue accumulated by contemplating on the bodhicitta and wisdom, then that's the way I will actually develop bodhicitta. So I have strong belief or certainty about the capacity, the qualities of bodhicitta and the virtue needed to develop bodhicitta. So this part of the verse is trying to develop delight, joy in this topic. So delight and joy to compose this text.
Koyu le tanang shi de shi yo de ma kepa tiyo de koyu ko le pecha tiyo le be ne ko tranji ge tuwa yong ge re sira ne ji ne nga nda bo tanda le tanang shi yo de ma tiyo de ne nga ge pecha tiyo le ko ranji ge te pa yong ti pe nang ji re sira ne jasi chen bo shi yo la ko shang chu ge sen le be ha chang te pa shu chen bo yo san ta ti ge je ja shi yo la ten ji tsom ba tre ya le ne ju ju pe ji na lo shu ni pa na de yong ge ti ge ting ge re sira.
And so here he's speaking about developing delight in the practice of bodhicitta. So because this is the favorite topic of Shantideva. Some people, their main topic will be maybe environment or medicine, poetry and so forth. So they will enjoy to compose about environment, medicine and so forth. Actually, Shantideva, what he wants is developing bodhicitta. His main favorite topic is bodhicitta. Therefore, he has delight in that. Therefore, he's going to put all the energy to compose this text.
Data kawa namba yin chi chang, chitin da tona ten, chosia, chitin diga, and it yin ding samba yopa titing resra. Kale, da teshi yende samba dala mesia diga, then yende tso majibarem, yende samba yopa de tanda wodi kogresra.
And so next we go through the last part of the verse 3 that is saying, if, however, these are seen by others equal in fortune to myself, it will be meaningful. So here he's showing, you remember just before when he was saying, I'm not composing for the sake of others, he's showing that others were something in general, but it was not a fact, because here he said, may people who are interested enjoy that teaching as well.
Ini dah tak kawan yang bahasa ini kerja sebenar, dah siapa jadi cuma siwal kerana kuaris, lah. Kawan yang bahasa ini kerana tanjawa. Shanchu senle, ane mipa chenpo, tepa shu chenpo yodi ra. O teo diga, jasi ki xiepa le loya ki shanchu, nepa yodi ki teo diga, ane pechante tongso na, teya le pento yonggiri songgo re, sera.
And so here he's saying, for me and the fortunate one, how he's saying the verse here, equal in fortune to myself. So me and the fortunate one is referring to, for all the people like myself, he's saying, that have a strong interest, a strong Yeah, motivation, a strong goal that is to develop bodhicitta and to go through the path, through the practices of a bodhisattva. For those people that share the same goal as myself, I'm composing this text. So those are the fortunate one.
Then di yanchi diga ci diga gavati yansena ani ta be ngindro na bore do res ra kare sena ani pe cha tsong la gipa kare yo gre ani kare jeja kare shin tsong gi ba ani yenda le pendo sano kanle ji thon pe cha tsong mi de yo ten ba res ta lang ji rim ba ngindro bo de ta tin ni di ci wo de ma ta pe ji le ong res ra
and also is kind of an introduction to settle the mind for the person who's going to follow this teaching or is going to read this composition. He's saying, so here we're showing what's the point or the purpose to compose that text, what's the topic or the subject of that text, and the fact that it's going to be benefiting others. So therefore, then we're going to enter in the topic itself, the wish to listen to this teaching. So next we go with the verse number 4, that is starting the first line, is saying the leisures and endowments are very hard to find. So here we're speaking about the perfect or precious human rebirth, and this is the beginning of the text, which main topic is going to be bodhicitta. So to exhort oneself, to realize oneself that we have this possibility to develop bodhicitta, then first to exhort ourselves, we need to identify that precious human rebirth.
And now
we're going with the verse number 4. The leisures and endowments are very hard to find, since they accomplish the purpose of beings. If I do not accomplish benefit upon this, how will I acquire this in the future? So this is the topic about recognizing, being able to identify, to recognize that we have this amazing opportunity right now. We have this so precious birth that we have to use right now. And based on that specific rebirth, we can obtain whatever we need in the future lives. We can obtain good rebirths in the future lives, and we can obtain our final goal as well. Yeah. So it will be completely a shame not to use that opportunity that is really amazing and really rare to obtain. So we should use it right now. So when we speak about the precious human rebirth that is so difficult to obtain, so this is a topic that we have seen last week, Segeshela. We've seen this point of contemplation on the precious human rebirth that is divided in the three aspects. Why is it so difficult to obtain? Why is it so precious? So in terms of the cause needed to obtain that, in terms of the example, usually giving example to show that or to illustrate it, and also by entity, recognizing the entity of that precious human rebirth. So usually there are the three points of contemplation when we think about the difficulty of obtaining precious human rebirth. Cause, example, entity. Or cause, entity, example. So usually when we speak about the precious human rebirth, there are these 8 and 10, so the 10 qualities, 10 fortune and endowment, or there's different way to call them. 18 qualities. So the first are four and fourth, so the eight qualities in terms of rebirth. So qualities in terms of being a human means, for example, not having reborn in the three lower realms, so in the hell, preta, and animals, and not having reborn neither as a god of long life. Yeah. So we've been reborn as a human. And not only that, but being reborn as a human, we have been reborn in the situation when where there is access to the Dharma. So there's the freedom of this kind of obstacle, such as being in being born in a time where there is no Dharma, when there is no teaching, in a land that is not where there is no access to the Dharma, when one doesn't have the complete sense powers full, and there was one more. And wrong views, not being completely like completely distorted with wrong views.
Any letter maldropasini, some make a lay sheep on a sheep merging Latin, some make a lay sheep to you, but never mind by ra. That Nella tapasini, any lendrenda, any denig son theodoly cheek tepayankira, or theodoly ranjong as a gressera.
And so the next, the ten fortunes or endowment, they are five referring to oneself and five referring to others. All this you have been studying previously now in the stages of the path. So, for example, is being reborn as a human with all the sense faculty functioning, with no irreversible karma, and with faith in the law of cause and effect and so forth. Those are quality, personal qualities needed to have what's called the precious human rebirth.
Sanje Shenda Tanchi Chi Temba Nenda Tijin Jusia Yesani and Sanje Shimba in the Ti Chi Tembas Ra and Tiga Tindig the Temba Latin and Driven on the Calcio Topashi Palang Todo Yimbas Ra. Any Dela Mipeshini ya Jis Tindig Korun Drebutoni Papi Combo Mato Chaya, Tindi Mipetani Temba Jis Hudo Yimbashi. Any Yenla Chita Sanji Pe Toi Tinchi Yankin Yobati.
And then next are qualities in relation to others, so the environment and so forth. So to being born in the place where there's access to the Buddha, where there are teaching, where there are the conduct of whatever has to be abandoned and whatever has to be applied in the practice is shown, and the teaching of the highest level of practice, and when one has also sponsor or people supporting oneself in the practice and so forth. So those are qualities that are actually mentioned by Nagarjuna in the letter to a friend. This is the root of this different division of the 18 qualities of precious human rebirth.
Any co tre medosiala tre google chug google the sa google lita mumbo tsoni chia google that and that the chi chugji the dentin san that co chugji botanda rere siwala jumbo tsu google sera no isa tinsan and jugun ni kawasia that nichagore sera.
So like the analogies like that, if you want to have crops of wheat or whatever, yeah, wheat for example, then you need to combine all the causes and conditions. You need to have the seeds, you need to have a perfect ground, you need to have water and sun and so forth, yeah? So here is the same when we speak about, when we say contemplate how it's difficult to obtain a precious human rebirth in terms of the cause. You can imagine to get a rebirth with all these 18 specific qualities, all of them together, very difficult, because each of these qualities require a different set of causes and so forth. So you can imagine how many causes have to be produced to obtain that result, that precious human rebirth as a result. That's why it is a thinking about the cause to obtain that rebirth, we can understand how difficult it is to obtain.
Ani ngogo ni ka ase ani naga momboji chi ni ni na ko naga nzon degresra ta naga chobji de bit nzon go ani san momboji ti chi de nzon go ani san ani ngogo ni ka ase atresra.
And also in terms of the entity, we can understand the entity of that, or the nature of that precious rebirth is a rebirth that is very specific because he has these 18 different aspects to be combined together. So we can understand as in nature, that precious human rebirth itself is very difficult to obtain because it's this combination of 18 aspects combined in one rebirth.
Ani sanje chuni shag semog doya loni ra. Ani denro ne ngenro ne denro shiwa ta. Denro ne denro shiwa te. Ani shag la sanje gul shag nonle dona yi nunung re sumo re sera. Ani denro ne ngenro shiwa ta. Ngenro ne ngenro shiwa te. Ani pe ngaso pe saje gul dona yi momo chag sumo re. Sanje gul denijil pe teni sumo re sera.
So then the comparison is, in terms of example, there's two examples. One is more about reflecting about the probabilities, the law of probabilities or percentage. Yeah, if we check amongst all the beings who are reborn, how many beings are in the lower realms, how many beings are in the higher realms, we can see the difference in number. The beings in the lower realms are like the grain of the sand, countless. But being on the higher rebirths are very few, yeah, like a very few. So in terms of probabilities, we can think about how difficult, how the probability to obtain a specific rebirth as a human in this with these 18 qualities is very few. And then the other example we mentioned last week during the teaching on the three principal aspects of the path, Geshe mentioned this example that is not renowned about the turtle. There's a turtle that is blind and is in the ocean, and how what's the possibility for this turtle to enter the the ring on top of the ocean, knowing that she go out every 10 years and so forth. So this example has been given, this analogy has been given before. You know, eh? You've got it before, no?
Tanjon da neba kasya teres ra. Ta tanjon ne shin de neba. She bu tendu thoba chuba la sen. She bu tendu bi ge liten thoba sya. Ta kare loga sen. En nga so liten de le. Ane so so randa yen ji ten ina. Nien ko da tatu kare ina. So so madu na te kare me du toli nipa yores ra. Nga so nzom de yores ra. Tinji.
Yeah, and so next, the next point to think about is like as a basis, we have this precious human rebirth. We have been reborn in this specific context as a human with those conditions. So what's the point here? The point is that rebirth can be very useful, whatever we want. For our own sake or for the sake of others, we need this basis, we need this this rebirth for to achieve whatever we need or want. Mm-hmm. And now, so what's the difference between us, for example, and Mother Teresa? No, are they very beneficial being for this world? The difference is that our rebirth is so precious because we have interest in practicing the Dharma, and based on practicing Dharma, we can obtain everything possible. Yeah, the highest goal can be obtained as well. So this is why it's called precious, because based on that rebirth, we have access and we can practice Dharma. Mm.
Ani shimi ten dua alga kausa ne pe tiya gun jitse malare pati o ceci leji sanjir tiya do ngasot kipa cicang res liten ro ani soso gun becen do le shini te dusu ngare mato ro.
And also based on that precious human rebirth, we can achieve everything. We can produce the cause to get good rebirth in the future lives. But not only that, we can also achieve the state of a Buddha in one life, as was shown by Gyeltsen Milarepa. We know the story of Geshe Milarepa, who achieved Buddhahood in that very one life. And this we can also obtain based on that precious human rebirth.
Ani nima Milarepa koru getu ge Milarepa la kesha itrawa res ra. Ani chuno siya wa nima karege sanje de shanchi sumba karege truba ina as ra. Karina, that and that you be zoned to the Tendagbe, and that Sigil Sanjin Rata, Nimag, Yang Nimag, Sanji, the Shanchu Samatana, Truba Injimazo, Tanda Litin, then they on to Jimares, they are true, so so Kuronoma, you say Malale, and it's Sugu, Churon Sugu Truba Inas, they are Huares, ra. And it's Churon, Churon at Truba in Batad, Churon in Ale, Ki, intend of Tsi Injeres, ra. Ina Chila Lota Chishiteres, ra, Chile Lota, Lota Dushiteres, Churon. Sungares, ra. Carer Sena, and also cog lomadic sansole, that social say lama malarepata, bear sonjan tuba insan, intent chamber tongo, raza. And nunchi carer Sena, so so yombashini, combaya, kali geni, yas, yapo chasm and hakogo mares, ra. Niman yapo yin by sanaton daddy. Things on any chig sead, maso yondashini, yapo chago insan, and it churro ten mepans in the gores, chile, so so yondashini, ya yapo chas, sanji tusmade, mepajita, kor senon ten zindigora tad, than niman yapo inba. Things on chil lota dushichiron, there is a jitimala called tusumares, ra.
So there was one close disciple of Geshe Milarepa who asked Milarepa, how does it come that you could achieve that state of great, great, highest state of realization in this specific life? Means that you have been an amazing practitioner already in previous life, isn't it? And then Milarepa answered to that disciple, he said, your main problem is wrong views. You have a distorted view of reality. It's not about, I didn't achieve that state of realization, that level of realization, just because of previous lives. I have my own practice. I put a lot of effort in the practice. By striving, this is what you achieve. Only by striving. If you're not putting effort, you will never get that level of realization. Therefore, this is your worst wrong view, thinking that the realization can be because of previous life realization. Actually, it's about practicing and putting a strong, very strong effort in the practice.
Oh, that she would tend to Catin Della, Neba Pemba Madrin, Shen Yondan Jobacalan, then didn't dig a ten sachabo take toy cozle, and then also so so good tenda, shimmy tenta, Taba the Tanchichin Bicombo Madubaina, and if Shin Jis Yonjaji leaked the Nendaji Nikard, that tank on the Connors Loba Nongiris, and if Jujim Mombo Tongua is any, the Hachanka near the Calicabu Shores and Goresra.
And so now that precious human rebirth should be used for the sake of achieving the highest goal, which is complete full enlightenment, the state of a Buddha. If not that, at least obtaining a favorable rebirth in the future lives to be able to achieve that that state of Buddhahood finally. Yeah, if we cannot get it right now, then at least getting favorable lives in the future up to achieving that final goal of Buddhahood. So we need to produce the causes and condition to achieve that. So Buddhahood, ultimately, and favorable rebirth in the next life in the temporary level.
Any telepair carriagosina, any noble Lenkandoni, noble Yosak Sajal Jano, Lesani, any noble Malembachi, any test also telecha Pune Mombo Yantele on the Chipar Chagas and Gores, Nanji Lamakit and Sungores, ra.
So the analogy that is always taught in the text that the Lama mentioned all the time is this one. He's saying, if you're not using that, if you're not taking the essence of that precious human rebirth right now, you're like the fool guy who went to this land, this island, where that was full of jewels, precious gems, and so forth, and came back empty-handed. You're as fool as that guy.
Kuma chila kuwa dres citigra, any that ten sachemon denaji, London, things on any that Shanchu sell Nansu Lengu, she goes there, that kuitsi res, kumashi cigra.
So, those words that we are seeing here, the purpose is to exhort us or to inspire us strongly to practice to develop bodhicitta. So, this is exhortation words.
That deal would it see the and Cassin deleta and the Maduaina, then Mace de Bajan Tuntuin, but Dingo Resera, the Jinsani, and it and then also she do the cousin and go to the Maduaina, Mace Hachan, Tuntun Reserati.
And so the next point to complete here is after contemplating about the precious human rebirth, then contemplating about the fact that this life is very short, so we don't have so much time left to practice. This life is very short. We should contemplate on that
point. Tenji Sanji to Yanana, Jitensana, Lodri Tangan Junsi at City Carcassina, and a Temo Mipa Naponolera. Temo Mipa Hacha Naponole, Lu Ma Chitinera, what Jiting has a send, digging into the words
and
words.
And so the next we go with the verse number 5 about impermanence and death, the shortness of this life. He's saying, just as a flash of lightning brightly illuminates for an instant within the clouds of a dark night, likewise in this world, through the might of the Buddha, merit and intelligence occasionally occur for once. So here what he's saying, that our life is very short, is like the lightning in the sky. In English is very clear. Yeah, what he said, the example that is given here. So we should remember that we don't have so much time.
Okay.
So now it's 10 minutes left. If you have question, we can go through question answer. French translator, you have a question? Okay. Kongema to pachik sa song ni tata changi mindu sa kon ki gyo chigere wa ti dizire wa chela sa uyiro wa Okay. De geshe la soso tola di geshe la logu kanjado
na logi
ya ya geshe kaneyin ba tene kare lo jonje vaye tene kare tik tik vaye nga se sulas sur tis sungro nan sa
ne nga sita jewa de jelo jitung ge chu chu re ji lo le jewa re sa ne lomba tunse de
chu
chu re ji ji chu chu re ji ra ane pe lumba chungse pe chungju tene resra tiche hachang pe dui kunji resra jame ge rine sa je se ta tyo tsui ko pe kali khes te tsui resra ti res ani ne chungse no lota chungju jin jinda somba ji ba pa do nga chungse lota jin ro no resra tini ne ani lo pe che lo jen ang ji le ani ropa no ropa zo shi de resra ani Lord, you do ne ane tabashi ba res tabachi ane tabachi sa de ngaso phai gemba chungchung jo res den ole chini pesha dan 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 lo jong xia yo ma res ngaso malang dan den ban dan de chuo ga xia le dong de de res ro o ten de xi ane nga ane deni nga chang do ndo res chang do
chang do
chang do gemba sen chen bo res taba tung ta ji de da den ole ane nga chini pesha da lo sum la ji de ba yes ane je chu cha go lo le ta bene te komba ji ado ane jaga tsi yong res je chu cha go ki to ge je cha go de no le ane te ma ni yong ar tong bo ji le sa ni ne ba le ge police ge zong pa jam pa ti ba re te res ane ji pe na le jam la sa pa de ji so sa ane la sa ma tang ane la sa le da ni de yong ja tsi yong yes yong ja tsi yong ni ya ne ba le police tu so sa de ina mayo ge pe sha te ya da ta ti ya de te yong tu res ra ta ane gu chi tam ba lo le Aranasle jaram chi tingkhong chi nangko ane aranasle pani
gochi
tambalo
okay, mm-hmm. okay. Mm-hmm. So the beginning of the story I was born in Segeshela okay I was born in 68 in a small village in an area of what's called Kham this eastern area of Tibet and because we were under the Chinese rules it was very difficult to study and so forth so we were a small village with a small school. So I went through maybe 3 years or 3 classes of study in that small school. And then for the next years, I've been mainly a nomad. So I was taking care of zoo, yeah, yaks and so forth in the countryside. And next, when I was 16 years old, I became a monk. And I was staying in the local Gompa monastery that was very small. So there was no way to study philosophy. So we were mainly doing pujas and things like that, rituals, but no study. And then later on, I went to this bigger Gompa in Chamdo. And there I could start to study philosophy for 3 years. Next, in 89, I tried to escape to India. So the first time I escaped, they caught me at the Nepalese border and brought me back to Lhasa. And then 2 months later, I tried again, and I could manage actually to arrive in India. And I arrived in 90 into Varanasi when His Holiness Dalai Lama was giving the Kala Chakra. So that's the beginning of the story. So then, after that, I went to the great monastery of Sira, South India. And I've done all my courses to become a Geshe, all the philosophical studies. And I registered for the Geshe exam in 2002. And after you register, if you're a normal monk, you need to wait. You're on the list, waiting list, and you have to go through exam every year and so forth, up to getting the final exam with public debate and so forth. That is happening usually 6 or 7 years after that. So I went through all the correct procedure, and I get my Geshe degree. And not only Geshe, but what is called Geshe Larampa, which is the highest level of Geshe. By the way, Larampa, I translated, the translator explained, Geshe Lati didn't say, yeah. And then Geshe La in 2008, after getting his Larampa Geshe degree, went to the Tantric College of Gyurme to do his Tantric studies.
And then,
And then later on, I came back to Sira, to the monastery of Sira, and I started to teach in the school and also to teach the first topics of philosophical studies, you know, the collective topic and then logic, all these things, yeah. So I started to teach the young monks between 6 and 10 years old, to teach them those topics. And for 2 years, I was in the school in Sira teaching. So I'm from, every monastery has their small group, small bubble, small residence. So I'm from the residence that is called Tsawa Kamse. So in my Kamse, in my residence, I had to play the role of the Geke disciplinarian for 1 year, I think. So I was disciplinarian of Tsawa Kamse for 1 year. Also at one point I could manage to stop a little bit with the activities, and I went into retreat for about 5 months. I went into retreat practicing the Yamantaka, doing the Yamantaka practice. And then finally, the last months before to arrive here, for maybe 4 or 5 months, I was in Root Institute, that is FPMT Center in Bodh Gaya. So I was there for the last months teaching Dharma there before to come here. So at first I was not supposed to go to Bodh Gaya, but actually I escaped Sira. Why? Because the point is that in Sira all the Geshe, they have specific commitment to serve the monastery. So Like in Sera, there is the Chöra. The Chöra is the place where all the monks join to debate, yeah, the big session of debate. And in the Chöra, in that place for the everyday daily debate, they need five Larampa, five Geshe Larampa, the highest level of Geshe, to be present, to be with the monks for the debate. So I was on the list to be on the next group of Geshe to be there. And the commitment is 2 years and is supposed to start now, this year. Mean that if I was to do that, I could not come for 2 years, and it was not the plan. So to avoid that commitment, I escaped to Root. I went to hide in the Root Institute while waiting for my yellow pass and all the passport and all the papers to be able to come here.
Kasi tana pa Root kison mando ayina ko yi lutsani nga kitsa ayina ane nga shiki mese gumba shiwa yo mares.
Yeah, because the point, if I started the 2 years as responsible for the Chöra, for the debate ground, then I could not stop this commitment. As I started, I should have stayed for the complete 2 years. There was no way to get out of it. So it was better to what they call ask permission or ask a leave before to start that commitment. If not, then I would not be coming here. So that was the trick. This is my little story. It was in the three first, right? Yeah. Realization of abandonment, yeah?
Yeah.
Okay.
And?
The second set. Okay, realization. Yeah. Positive one. The complete one was the third one. So you want to clarify the third one. Okay. Geshe la te tang po di quand j'as pang pa sum tang tok pa sum dans la lek pa tem pa tang milu wa re wa
milu wa mali ba chim ba
malu pa mali pa chim ba di tan ta kare re sa ta ma ta ma di malu pa
mali ba chim ba se ni shi ya ta da ro wa ng sum do chi mali ba chim ba se ni chi ta wa jin se ni di ni chi cha ng sum do chim ba na bo
go re se ro
अने शिता माली बच्चे में से आदे गांसो संजीग मातो चीन तुग मारे सरा करे से ना लेंड्रे ठासी ठावायो रा ले जुन्डे ठामो तियो दे अने संजीग मातो अंगसों चीन तुग मारे सरा माली बंग अंगसों चीन बादे तीन इंसान माली बच्चे में से लोगों रे सरा
So actually to be more precise, Okay. So the question was about when Geshe was mentioning the three aspects of the realization of abandonment and the three aspects of the positive realization that are specific to a sugata. Yeah. So in terms of the three aspects of realization, the second set, he was saying, so it's perfect. First one is perfect, second is stable or steady, and the last one that is complete without exception. Yeah. What does it mean here? It means that only a sugata, only a Buddha, is able to perceive all phenomena, the two truths, all phenomena, yeah, two truths, simultaneously and completely, without exception. So it's only a Buddha who is able to do that. And also, for example, Buddha is the only one who knows all phenomena, such as the most subtle aspect of the cause of law and effect, karma. Yeah, only a Buddha can know all this most subtle, refined aspect of karma. So Buddha is only one who knows all phenomena, even the more subtle one, and who knows simultaneously the two truths in terms of all phenomena.
Tanda lendre chashi thaw ngsong se ade ani chenang ge yimbad na dai tong bai na ra ani tig ndre bo tichi ndanda jil hi gres yun ndanda jil hi gres er ndre bo lungshi ndanda jin jung gres ani pe na ani dewa ina dewa chi ndanda jil hi gres ani tindi ge chi tindi sa bo chin khe de sanji ge ma to chin tu ge ma re sa ra tin san mali ba chin ba se
And complete also in the term of, for example, karma, knowing all the aspect, all the details of the karma, only a Buddha can say by this specific action that you've done right now of generosity, the result will maturate or will ripen at that specific time, in that specific location, and it will manifest in that specific experience. Only a Buddha can give all these details in terms of a specific karma, in terms of the result of a specific action. So it's also part of the complete, yeah, complete realization in terms of knowledge. You want, we ask them? Okay. Geshe la ti, kose longa, zerim longa yereva, basic program sarvate longa gorki reva. Ta gune la mna loshi reva. Tende geshe la pet shuye yereve, yamena teje la pancho ye tachik shempa yereve.
Tati jemba yo mares ra. Tati jemba yo mares, shitande diyak chayi yores ra.
So the question, yeah, maybe I translate the question as well. No? So he's asking if Geshe-la plan to stay for the whole program, for the whole basic program. So Geshe-la say, of course, I have no other plan than this one. I'm staying. Okay.
Ouf.
Ou l'espagnol.
He's
actually, so question if Geshe was planning to learn English or French, yeah? And he said, yes, I started already to learn English. I have this amazing teacher that is just here. Lekso, Venerable Lekso is the teacher. So he's studying English with Venerable Lekso.
Okay.
Okay. So he has class every day, right? 11:30, they have class, and I was checking how is the teacher. He's very good. So there's hope. Okay. So from the bottom of my heart, I say thank you very much, teacher.
So to dedicate the merit, we go to page 89. Chancho semcho grin poche mai ke pa nan ke kyur chi ke pa nyam pa me pa yang kone kondo pel bar sho ton ni ta va rin poche mai ke pa nan ke kyur chi ke pa nyam pa me pa yang Kone kondo pel bare shu kandri rabe korbe shinkandir pendain deva madi jungme ne chere zikvan tenzin gyatso yi shabe zite badu ten gyore chi tonyi nyin che sondo jukpe lam che che selze Chagna pemo tenzin gyatola Silva depso shidun dun jochu To tel chayn chin chan gyn gilwe Tenzin kyun pelwe kyn ze dog poren ze Choson kurwe leg mun to do Bahadai sodil jekendu shabten shum Jumbel Babo Jitar again Bada in Kinton Sangpo de Yang de Shin de De Dagen Kijitso Dagdo Jirigil Wadi Dai Dam Chir of Tong De Sun Jake Gil Wadam Jake Go Wagon Dajo Toing Akbade Dagi Gibet Zabadi Kunya Sangpo je jirab dung o varegi, la basum den yur midzin bai, de pezo gine de yong hainjin, tak to shedru jabe ziteba, to den jo jurge beta shisho.
Just a small thing about the text that we are studying. First of all, it's good to have this text on, of course, the root verses. I think everybody has the root verses. We have a special edition with the outlines by Gyeltsen J in it. So that's very nice to have that there. Then you know better where you are in the text. So when you look at the server, it's the in the English part. It is the fourth from the bottom. Yeah, that is the one. The engaging in the Bodhisattva Deeds together with the outlines from the commentary by Gyeltsen J. So it's good to have that. And then we have the commentary.